Hi, welcome to Heartfully Creating. Lessons learned today about UV resin. Do I even like it? So here, I just want to share what I've learned, and I guess a bit of a review overall of what I've learned so far in learning to use the epoxy and UV resin. And I've actually tried about 4 different kinds of UV resin so far.
I've been talking lately about my lessons learned with UV resin. So one of them was, don't use molds like this because the UV light can't get through it. So I had this brilliant idea to try a different experiment, which was to take mica powder or just some pigment powder and use a brush and put it into the mold. The theory being that then the mica powder would be in the mold on the surface only, just the surface, because remember, I'm thinking UV light can't get in, so how could I get it in and still be able to use these molds with some UV resin? Well, guess what? Didn't work. So I poured the UV resin in, and then again, thinking that the light would go through because it's coming down through the top, right? So thinking that all of this would get hit and there would be no curing difficulties. Well, last night, thinking, oh yeah, what a brilliant idea, genius. Then I went to take it out and I already rehardened it because it's so messy, but all this was raw, for lack of a better word, all ooey and gooey. The worst thing I hate about UV resin. So I had to flip it over carefully just to cure it, to get it so I could handle it without making a huge mess. And the mess it left in there, it didn't even pull off the mica powder. It stayed in there. It was just gross. So again, I stand by my advice to not use opaque molds for UV resin, or you'll be sadly disappointed. And that would include, these type of things, they're called like push molds. You can use these with polymer clay probably, but a lot of the ones I think that I'm getting on eBay that are really cheap, I'm probably getting what I pay for, and maybe that's it too, I don't know. But if you think about it, if you look at your mold closely, so use a mold that's open completely, like something like this mold here. I used this one. I did the same thing with this one. This is a clear mold, so it works anyway. And I did the mica powder on the inside and poured the resin. And you do get a matte finish because there's powder. And of course, that does cure, right? Because you also have this nice translucent mold, which is way, way better. So those molds are okay on eBay, but definitely, well, I think can't guarantee that they'll all be okay. It would have been a kind of a cool fish, would add a bit more color. I did try to use a white mica powder that changes color depending which way you look at it, but it didn't really pick it up. Again, it left it in the mold basically. So all these edges that fold over, because if someone's making a cast of this to turn this into a mold, whoever did this, they're going to push it into the silicone. The silicone wraps around the item, and then you have a bit of a lip underneath. So your UV resin will not get cured under there because inside there, yeah, it can't get in there. However, it didn't cure right here in the middle. So explain that, somebody. Yeah, it's even pretty translucent and pretty thin right there in the mold. Oh well. So that was the bummer part. The lesson learned. Just wanted to share that.
I hope that provides a little bit of useful information. Again, that's just my experience. I would love to hear from you if you have had a much better experience regarding using opaque molds and UV resin. As well, we'd love to hear about what your favorite UV resin is and any points and tips and tricks you might have. Just please comment down below. And don't forget to check out the corresponding blog at heartfullycreating.blogspot.com. As well, it really helps if you like, share, and subscribe. But no pressure, only if you want to. And Happy New Year, by the way.